Barry Price, simply put, he has been magnificent this season. The NHL's leader in wins, in goals against average, in save percentage. Nobody has been better than Carey Price. Jonathan Bernier grew up 30 minutes away from Montreal, so you know he wants a strong game against the Canadiens tonight. He has only one win in 8 starts, however, against Montreal. Referees are going to be Greg Kimmerly and Kevin Pollock. Greg Dvorsky, John Grant will work the lines tonight. Sellout crowd, of course, over 18,000. The Maple Leafs in the blue, Canadiens in the white with a red and blue trim. Vanek, Brewer, Bozak, Kessel, Van Riemsdyk starting for the Maple Leafs. Canadiens come after him right away. Centering pass was bumped along the side of the net by the Maple Leafs. Lupul off the boards to center. Holland took it, went in. Holland ready. Passed in front of the net. The first big save of the game by guess who? Carey Price has been doing it all season, and that was a dandy. So no score yet, nearing 3 minutes of the first day.
More scoring from different sources, and Eller gets the first good chance of the hockey game here. A little stop and start, and that doesn't get through. And at the other end, when Montreal are so aggressive on the forecheck, they often get caught in man advantage situations defensively, but they got the goalie Price, and that's why they can get away with it. More scoring from different
guards. Still inside that Canadian line. No score, first period, Kessel. Off the boards with a pass, Van Riemsdyk left it. McWilliams shot. Price wasn't fooled, he was waiting for that. His center, score! And he was not ready for that. A wraparound by the Maple Leafs coming in as Price made the first save, and then the puck was loose, and there was Kessel.
Well, the Montreal Canadiens at one end get a pretty good look because Vanek gets caught off ice in the 2-on-1. And Gallagher just fails to connect. Bernier, give him credit. He got across in a hurry and got a piece of it. And then at the other end, Carey Price may be looking the wrong way here as he goes around. Yes, in that 1 second where he peeks over his left shoulder, Phil Kessel comes from behind the net and sneaks it in between his legs to give the Leafs the first goal of the hockey game.
At 3:58 of the first period. He had just made the save and then wasn't quite set, and Kessel was. He took advantage. Giveaway, Desharnais scores! This Canadian team can fly. And Desharnais can fly. He was right there and had a beautiful shot to tie the game.
Well, Jonathan Bernier, not knowing for his puck handling ability, although usually he's pretty good in tight. So he finds Kadri up the middle, and Kadri just plain isn't ready for this. A bit in his skates, and Desharnais, who's a sniper, gets in position A.
Well, unless you start taping a blade of a stick onto Kadri's skate, I don't know how you're supposed to handle that, but you know, the smelling salts work, right? That's how you start your game. Well, two shifts into it, he's got his first goal for the Montreal Canadiens.
Maybe they can pass you some, Hills.
Less is more, and Millsy, you and I, the way we handle the puck, that was always the way we did it.
So the Leafs score, and then 16 seconds later, Canadiens tie it up. 1-1, they haven't hit 5 minutes of the first period yet at the Air Canada Center. Look at Eller go in. He dropped it back, and Wiese's shot is just wide. Beaulieu stopped it at the blue line. Looks ahead, a nice pass. The Canadiens are playing well inside that Leaf line. Good passing. Hard, still inside. Yes, cross ice. Shot in around the net. Back there is Peter Holland again. Looks out. Goes to the line with it for Phaneuf. He shot it, score! The Maple Leafs get a lead. That's deflected in there. Peter Holland. And Casey Bailey is going to get the goal, and that's his first in his career, and he picked up the puck. Holland got it for him, his first goal, and gives the Leafs a lead.
You always remember this moment as a player, I would think. Being a goalie, I wouldn't know it, but look at the reaction here. A harmless-looking shot that goes towards the net. Not bad, scoring your first National Hockey League goal against the Montreal Canadiens.
known for his great shot. He's got three on the year, and his first goal is a simple deflection.
Leafs clear it out, though, a little race.
Bailey getting it again, don't tell me. No, he's stopped by Carey Price. Got his first career goal at 14:04. And here now, nearing the 18-minute mark, he nearly got a second.
Pleading his case, and then when he put his arms up, the referee's arm went up. And here's Bailey in. How often you get a goal in the league and it goes right to your legs. And boy, I haven't seen him skate like that since he's been a Maple Leaf, and a real good play. Pleading his case
to him off a stick. Canadians cover well. Kessel backhanded the pass ahead, and it's played out by Plekanec. That'll do it. Clearing down across the line. Coming in. Drop pass. Kharkov, another pass. They score. What a beautiful goal. Plekanec scoring on the third pass, heading for the net. And the Canadians here in the first minute have tied the game.
Well, before this play starts, Kessel gets one right in the chops here in a follow-through. No penalty because it's a follow-through, and then the counter-attack. Now, the Leafs are not in bad shape here, but it becomes actually a 4-on-2 as all three forward for the Maple Leafs get caught up ice. And then a pretty little play, Smith-Pelly over to Markov, and then a finish by Gallagher on the transition from Bernier, trying to get from one side of the net to the other, and it goes right through him.
To him off his ice. Nearly got a break, too. Tatarin covered up in time. Long pass by Beaulieu up over the line, and the Canadians attack once more. This rebound right to Prostoff, the goalie. Shot it over in front of the net, and a big save by Bernier to keep the game tied.
Oh, Bernier with a pretty good transition to get across that time. And Panik here almost beats Carey Price again from behind the net. And here is the Bernier save, getting across. And right on top of the crease on Flynn, who didn't get all of that puck.
It's a good fourth line. Flynn and Mitchell play together in Buffalo. They've got good chemistry, and Pruss can play with anybody. Fourth line they didn't have last year.
Price nearly is going to the net, didn't get there in time. Van Riemsdyk has it. Way back to the line, O'Reilly. And right in front of the net, big save by Price there. Tip and attempt by Bozak. And Price got a piece of it. In front, they score! Tyler Bozak stayed there. And the Maple Leafs are ahead again.
Montreal Canadiens in this game have had a difficult time in their own zone. They've been very loose throughout the game. And Price has to make the first 10 Beller save. And then Subban loses the puck battle behind the net. And a pretty little pass. Finds Bozak wide open in front. And we've watched Van Riemsdyk do this before. Just throw it between his legs out after Kessel kicks the puck to keep the puck alive. Bozak with the quick release solves Carey Price, who really never recovered from that first 10 Beller on the same sequence.
He's going to the neck again, back to the line. Markov over here. Subban put it in deeper. Galchenyuk made a dandy move. Hit the side of the goal. It's cleared out and down the ice. Great looking power play right there for the Canadians. But it was cleared. Now Markov dancing up. Cut in over the line, shot the puck deep. Back there was McWilliam. He missed a chance to pick it up. It'll be Markov who'll stop it at the blue line. Backhands it into Gallagher. Back out to Subban. He lost it. Subban trying to cover up for that stick. Holland gets the puck in deep. Holland after another chance in front of the net. The backhander. Rebound right there off Price. And the Leafs nearly get a shorthanded goal. Markov. Subban. Again, back to way. Here's Brewer going himself. In over the Canadian line, hands it off. Good chance here. The shot is in wide of the net, though. Parties pound each other in front of the goal, and look out now.
Yemelin came across on Brewer, and it was a bit of a low bridge, and Brewer certainly didn't take too kindly of it. Now you get Ben Reemsdyke going after him as well. Brewer immediately got up right after. And here's the Emelin play coming across. A little hip check. And here comes Brewer. Oh! Straight arm right across the face.
Boston, Tampa, 1-1 we hear. Emelin, he likes the rough game.
Well, that was a nasty play by Emelin, and Brewer got right up.
Here's away. He eludes that first checker. Got the pass down, that was picked off. And shot in deep by Markov of the Montreal Canadiens. 10 seconds left. Score! Jacob Delarose just coming up, and the puck came right to his stick. And the Canadiens tie it with 8.9 seconds left.
What a killer for the Maple Leafs, and Jonathan Bernier twice tonight now. He's had difficulty handling the puck. A routine play, he goes behind the net, looks, goes to his backhand, and it gets into the feet of Jake Gardner, and with that, Gardner's calling for it. He goes in the reverse play. Delarose just sneaks in, and it ends up right on his tape with the goaltender still behind the net.
Fourth goal of the season for him. A big one it is for the Canadiens. With no time left now to talk about with the faceoff at center. Shot by Reese was stopped. Cleared over the line, and that should do it for period number two. But we may not be finished. Orr is on the ice, and he grabs Subban, who dealt the hit. And the linesman and a referee is over to make sure nothing develops here. Oh, my. They settle him down. Thank goodness. Here's how it developed. A hit at the blue line by the captain of the Leafs. And now Subban comes in. And there is Orr. Look out.
Orr has 118 fights in the NHL. I guarantee 119 is not going to be against PK Subban. He's smarter than that.
Montreal outshot the Leafs away. Nathan Beaulieu starting up to the blue line and takes off the center and dropped it back. Back up to him at the Leaf line and feathered in Gallagher. He missed that far side. Good chance for him too. Didn't really get all of it. He's on the puck again, coming in front of the goal, and he stopped. Scramble for it. The Leafs take over and get it up on the blue line area. That stop out there and given up by Pettering the other way. Pekanec now looking at the goal. Tipped in front, stopped by Bernier. Dandy save again. And he smothers it. And no further play.
As he looks to the sky, because he has been around it all night long. And Brendan Gallagher right off the start of the game. Went to the net, fanned on that one. Side of the goal again. That's too high. Can't pick that one out of the air. Another opportunity where he's preset. Turns away. And then goes to the net in the second period, and then in this third period does exactly the same thing and almost gets rewarded for it. You love the way he plays. Here's the redirect, Bernier with the good save moments ago.
Nathan Beaulieu starter on this side. Back to the blue line. Canadiens power play looking pretty good. They're 0 for 2 in the game. Coming up, Pekanec centered it. And a big save by Bernier. Loose puck. Leafs can't clear it. Pekanec shoots. That stop. Pekanec tipped it back to the line. Subban right in front of the net. They score. Well, the big crowd and the Canadiens celebrate the lead goal, 4-3. Subban, how about that?
Gallagher, we featured him all game long, and a good example of his character. I mean, he gets flattened right on the seat of his pants, and on the same shift, what does he do? He just gets right up and keeps battling. Against two, this time Erickson, and he just battles. Bernier doesn't like it. He thinks he's getting interfered with, and Gallagher finally gets rewarded for all the hard work throughout this game after Subban puts it towards the net, and Gallagher goes to the net, finds and hunts out the puck. Bernier doesn't like the fact that he got pushed a little bit on the play, and that's why he said, hey, I didn't have an opportunity to stop that puck. I was shot before the puck went in. Another look at it.
He's right.
And he's right. Absolutely.
Should be no goal.
Absolutely, he's right. But you said Subban, who stopped the puck inside the blue line and kept it going and dumped it into the crowd. Somebody had to score. Now they're making the call. No goal.
There you go.
Good on the referees and the linesmen for getting together and debating this, which is certainly legal. Without a review video-wise, which will happen in the future, not now, but they made the right call.
And Glenn, we've done this before. Bernier, right away, he gets up and goes after the ref. And if he doesn't make his case and do that, that may not have happened. That's what you have to do when you're a goalie. You got to get up, at least give it a shot. He goes right after the official, gets up and pleads his case. And one of the rare occasions, he wins it. Although, the Montreal bench doesn't like it much.
Greg Kimmerle, the referee, you just saw there on the bench.
And Bernier looking for the ref, goes right after them. And then, as you mentioned, Glenn, all the refs get together at the penalty box and they make the right call.
On this side.
No, Bozak. Phaneuf was on the ice. That tells me a lot about the character of some of the players.
Here's Kessel all alone going in. Great save by Carey Price.
Knocked down at the line by Phaneuf. No, it came outside the line and it was offside. Kessel has had chances.
It's been the story of the second half since the All-Star game for Kessel. It just won't go in. And he's had plenty of opportunities. Shows the speed, quick release. And when you're playing against the best goalie in the world, kind of makes it look easy, like Carey Price did there.
He gave him the entire side of the net. Kessel had his head up, and as soon as he went to release it, Carey said, "What you see isn't what you get." No, Bozak.
Now Chenyuk is going to start it off for Montreal.
Leafs chose for Montreal to go first.
He's a great stick handler, this young man, getting better every season. Let's see how he does on this final game of the regular season. Galchenyuk scores! A beauty! What a stick hammer. Oh, you like that?
I like the delay. Delay, delay, delay. And then wait, and Bernier bites, and then he just throws it up over top.
Mozak for the Toronto Maple Leafs. And he's not too shabby, let's face it. Weaves his way in. Not on Price, he misses the net. The thing about a goalie like Price, he'll stand up and look at you like, listen to me talking to two goalies here alongside me tonight, but he'll make you shoot for the post, and you can't miss. Desharnais, there's a guy that the Canadiens are just so happy with over the last few seasons. Now all he needs is score! Bullet shot.
What is it, Frank Mahovlich, Bob? Haven't seen that in a while. Come in at about 35 kilometers an hour and over the glove at 90.
Lupul has to keep it alive. That's all. He can't. Because Carey Price stands tall again. And the Canadiens win in overtime. Good night, Toronto Maple Leafs. One more win for the Canadiens. And the Stanley Cup playoffs are coming up for the Habs.
And one more win for Carey Price. He grabs the puck knowing it was another significant win for him.
Now, here are the Maple Leafs. A tough, tough season. The fans were tough on them for a while, but you know what they're doing now? They're standing. I can hear some boos.
A lot of boos. Some cheer.
And that's growing. And this season is gone for Toronto. A louder saying, thank heavens.
And will this be Lupul's last shot as a Maple Leaf? Perhaps. Atta boy, Carey. What a year you've had.
What a year the Canadiens have had. What is next? as they go for the Stanley Cup. George Stramboulopoulos.
Thank you, Bob Cole. Great job as always, sir.
On entend des huées ici au centre Air Canada. Alors les Leafs qui vont rater les séries pour une neuvième fois au cours des 10 dernières années. Mais nous, nos énergies sont concentrées vers les Canadiens de Montréal. Les Canadiens qui vont affronter les Sénateurs d'Ottawa au premier tour éliminatoire. On retrouve Renaud avec Piquet Subban.
Piquet, number 50. What a season.
Yeah, it's been a great year. We play a lot of good hockey. I thought we came out with the right effort today. Things didn't go our way. I mean, we didn't have very many opportunities. I thought we should have had more opportunities on the power play, but we stuck with it. We had some big kills, and obviously Carey shut them down when we needed them the most.
Are you satisfied with the way this season was for your team?
You know, I judge our season based on the playoffs, and, you know, right now we've had a great regular season, but we've seen a lot of teams over the years have great regular seasons and have a short playoff run. We want to have just as great a playoff run as we did regular season.
I've got one last for you because there's a lot of players from the other side on the ice. The Ottawa Senators, you're going to face them next week. Is it something that you're happy to hear?
You know what? Listen, this is the playoffs. I really don't care who we play. You got to beat everybody to win a Stanley Cup, and they're just a team we're going to have to go through first.
Have a nice one, Piquet. Merci.
Thanks.
Piquet Subban qui dit, écoutez, là, peu importe qui on va affronter en séries éliminatoires, ça ne change absolument rien pour nous. On sait maintenant que ce sont les Sénateurs d'Ottawa. Ça n'a pas été un match facile pour les Canadiens. Il le reconnaît. Beaucoup de frustration, de beaux arrêts de Carey Price qui a fait encore une fois la différence. Mais le Canadien qui remporte donc une 50e victoire cette saison.
De David Dernay qui a marqué un but spectaculaire ce soir en fusillade.
Oui.
David, après la première période, dans ton visage, évidemment, il y avait un peu de mécontentement parce que présence qui avait fait en sorte que les Maple Leafs avaient marqué leur deuxième but. Je pense que là, ce soir, 50e victoire dans une saison, les sourires sont revenus.
Oui, non, c'est sûr. Après une période, des fois, on n'est pas content, mais le résultat était là ce soir. On a revenu deux bonnes périodes, puis on était capable d'aller chercher la victoire.
On peut dire que c'était toute une troisième. Là, ça ressemblait presque à un match de série en troisième période.
On s'approche de ça. Et c'était pas mal notre dernière période. C'est ça qu'on voulait. Puis on a fait un bon travail. Puis comme je l'ai dit, on était allé chercher la victoire.
David, c'est pas évident de faire des prédictions dans la Ligue nationale de hockey parce qu'on regarde les Bruins de Boston ne feront pas les séries, puis ils ont quand même 95 points et peut-être même plus. Mais 50 victoires, est-ce que tu t'étais imaginé le Canadien cette saison qui pouvait atteindre ce plateau-là?
Écoute, on dit jamais, faut jamais dire jamais, comme
ouais,
on dit. Mais,
on veut gagner 82 matchs.
Ouais, c'est ça, mais non, avec ce qu'on a fait l'année passée, on a un bon groupe de gars, on était capable. C'est sûr que c'était une grosse tâche, mais je suis content de faire partie de ça, puis on a un bon groupe de gars.
Moi, je me souviens, il y a deux ans, le Canadien qui affronte les Sénateurs d'Ottawa, Lars Seller, qui tombe au combat dans le premier match, Max Pacioretty, votre capitaine à l'époque aussi, Brian Gionta, et on dirait que ça a mis fin presque à cette série-là. Là, maintenant, vous avez votre revanche. Est-ce que vous êtes content d'avoir cette revanche-là?
Je te dirais que oui. C'est comme tu dis, je pense que c'est pas des bons souvenirs qu'on a contre cette équipe-là en série, puis on veut se rattraper.
Justement, les Sénateurs, quand même, c'est une bonne équipe de hockey, mais vous avez aussi une très bonne équipe de hockey. Vous arrivez là avec confiance?
Écoute, tu viens de le dire, on a 50 victoires. Je pense qu'on n'a rien envié à personne. On se sent bien, on joue bien, puis ça va être à nous autres de démontrer qu'est-ce qu'on sait faire dans les séries.
Et on a bien hâte de voir ça. Puis merci beaucoup, David. Félicitations pour ta saison.
Merci.